Let us now move on to the key concept 3, which is auto generation with UI component. This concept aims to bring it the various capabilities that UI component as an element exhibits in order to provide a high amount of sophistication and customization for the UI screens that we are building. So let's get started. So let us revisit the concept of UI route and templates. So basing on the configuration information that we are giving as part of the UI route, we will mention two important things. One is the path, which will contain the model name, and what is the template which should be used in order to render this particular component here. So that information is available in the import section. So therefore, finally, what happens is the different pieces of information that is contained in the UI route with respect to the path and then import will be used, and then a final UI component will be constructed, and that will be rendered as part of the DOM. So this is what is happening. This brings us to the next important question. How to handle customization while we are doing a form rendering? So there can be multiple scenarios where we would like a facilitation from the oecloud. So the scenarios could be in a template, supposing that we have multiple containers. We have seen this already, that when it is dynamically rendering the into the containers, it will specifically look for one container called fields, and then it renders all the properties which are there in a model into that. So if we have a scenario where a particular set of properties should be rendered into one container and the rest should be going into another containers, how does this particular scenario work in this? The next scenario could be the field order and positioning. By default, the properties of a given model are exactly inserted into this div whose ID is fields into the same order of the creation. But supposing that we want a variance in terms of the field order and positioning, then we would have a need for customization. And the next scenario is, how do we add tooltips to the fields? Sometimes we either have models with less restrictions in terms of the validations, or more restrictions. But what we want to do is we want to implement a separate validation layer at a UI level. So we will have to therefore override a certain field configuration which is coming from the model. So this is one more level of customization. And finally, the globally overriding types is all about the formatting of the different elements in which they should be rendered. So this calls for another level of customization. Now let us take each one of them and then observe one example for them. So the first one is a dynamic rendering of content into specific containers defined in templates. So assuming that this particular template has got two containers, one is field, second is details. So you could, by means of the mentioning of the field ID, you will be able to specify a particular property from this product which should be rendered into what container. So for example, name is getting rendered into fields here, and the field called active is getting into the details container. And the next scenario we'll discuss is field order and positioning. Suppose there is a product model, and this product model is created in a particular order of the specification of the properties. But if you want to change that, you could have a fields array in which you could actually specify what are the different fields that you require in terms of the properties, and what exactly is the order in which they should be rendered. And it is possible to add tooltips. So therefore, you need to add a tooltip property with the message ID and then the default value. And by doing this, you will be able to add the tooltips for the more complex fields. And the next scenario is overriding certain fields. Suppose there is a product model and with a field called price. And the price field is not having any validations as part of the model definition. So therefore, you can bring in the additional model validations at a UI level. For example, you could build an attributes array here using which you will be able to specify that it is actually you require an attribute called required, which should be attached with the field called price. And finally, with respect to the globally overriding types, there is a default mechanism by which the date field will get rendered. But if you want to attach a different kind of formatting, you will be able to do that with this attributes array. So this is how the globally overriding types works. oecloud.io's UI component model brings in several interesting options to define client-side validations through a configuration and no-code approach. So let us discuss some of the possible validations. So they are making a field required. You could disable and hiding a field, pattern validations, min-max validations, multi-field validations. It provides a range of validation options. So let us take a look at making a field required. So you could see that there is a in the UI component model, there is a section called fields in which there is a field ID which is nothing but the name of the property from the model, and where exactly it should be rendered, it is mentioned as part of the container. And this is where you are introducing a UI level validation where required, you are making it as true. So this is how you do this. So while you are developing the UI component, in the fields, you have a field ID for which you have this required property, you are making that as true. And also sometimes it is possible that you would like to make a field ID as required only when a certain option is clicked. For example, price should be required when the field active is set to true. So therefore, that is a data bound here. So it is possible to disable or hiding a field. In this code, we are enabling flavors only when the flavorable is checked. So it is possible to implement a certain pattern validations. For example, this code implements a regular expression where we want code to follow the pattern one uppercase followed by four digits. And it is possible to implement min and max validations. So offered since date to be on or after 1st Jan 2012. And it should not be after the current date. Similarly, you are defining a minimum value for the price to be 0.01, so as shown in the code here. So far, the first four validations are concerned, they are restricted to one field at a time. But it is also possible to implement multi-field validations, and oecloud.io's UI component model is very rich with respect to the implementation of them. There are several validators that are of type multi-field validators, and let us take a look at some of the code samples. First, to start with the oeq validator or not equal to validator. So therefore, you could use this type as OE any validator, which is not equal to validators, where fields code and name should not have the same value. So therefore, by mistake, it is possible that code and name will contain the same value. So therefore, you are restricting the entry with respect to this particular validation. We use the LT validator or LE validator for number and date fields, where a validation that one value must be less than the other one. So, for example, the start date of a deposit should not be less than the maturity date and so on. So, we can use these validators to build these kind of validations. And we have a combination validator, which is an interesting validator. So when you have two fields, for example, here you have a category and then flavorable. These are the two fields, And there are only certain combinations of the values are permissible into this. So using this combination validator, you will be able to specify a range of combinations here. Observe that this is an array in which you mention what are the possible combinations for category and flavorable here. For example, when the category is coffee, the flavorable has to be false. And if the category is coffee, the flavorable has to be true. So these are the two possible combinations. But for a category of bakery, the flavorable has to be false. And category of soft drinks, the flavorable has to be false. So in these are the valid combinations between the category and flavorable. In case these are not submitted as part of the JSON payload, then you get this particular error saying that only coffee can be flavorable. So this is how you trigger an error message. And you have a OE expression validator where you will be using the expression language in order to write certain custom validations. For example, you could build a validation in terms of the expression here, and it evaluates an expression to decide whether the participating fields are valid or invalid as shown in the code. Now let us look at OE async validator. So you will use this if some of the validations are dependent on additional data from the server. So this will actually fetch that additional data, and basing on that you could take the decisions. So these are the different client-side validations which can be attached to a UI component model, and that's what makes this UI component model to be very powerful in rendering the custom forms. So having understood the range of capabilities of the UI component model, now let us do a code review of a UI component for the product model.